So for 11, what we have to do is have you transition from student to professional. And so one other thing you're going to be doing is producing professional looking as well as professionally content in your written reports. And so what goes in a report? Well, we're going to start off with a title. And give this some formatting. You all think you know how to utilize Word, but trust me, many of you do not. It's weeks away and you're going to be a professional, and so start acting like a professional now. Make your documents look professional, have professional content. Don't give me student work, I don't want to see it. What else is going to be here? You're going to have things like the name. You're going to have things like email. And you're going to have things like the date. Spell out the date, by the way. If you're going to work in an international setting, you don't want to have 5/4/2018. I don't know if that's May or April, because the different parts of the world use a different scheme of things. You're going to have an abstract. And four things go in the abstract. And you don't write the abstract first, you write the abstract towards the end, because you pull out the pieces from everywhere else. And so in the introduction, we define the audience for you. And so the audience is your boss's boss. This is somebody who's going to be technical, but they may not know exactly why you're doing your particular run, your particular component. And so one of the things that really helps people is by having an informative title. Right? So don't put lab one or anything like that. You want to have a title that when you look for the material in 4 years' time, you'll be able to find it, and it's indicative of what you're going to cover. Now, don't put measuring or determining in the title, because that's not what we're doing. We're going to be using data to make decisions. And so an informative title are related to the content. So the introduction is aimed at explaining one thing, and that is, how is the data used? And so in industry, if we are going through the process of spending money, your time, equipment, etc., then we need to know how that data is going to be used, what's it going to be influencing. And because it's being focused on the audience being the boss's boss, there's no need to go into some of these basic components. So don't tell me why the wind blows. They're going to know this. Right? Focus on how wind velocity or how elemental composition of coal is utilized in the decision-making process. So because I didn't write that very well, let me just redo it. How is the data used? So that's the focus. And of course, as you're writing this, you're going to be having citation markers. And you should be using a software to generate the citation markers for you. Next component that we're going to see will be the theory. Now, this is unusual to have this. It's very much because we want to know how equipment functions. How? An exclamation of how it works. So I'll give you an example with things like light bulbs. It doesn't work by throwing a switch. What I want to know is that there's a glass envelope in which there's a low pressure vacuum, or an inert gas in some cases, a tungsten filament that with electricity going through on an AC sequence will generate high heat. And we have luminescence from the temperature of the filament, photons being released and heat. And then that's how the light bulb works. And so for our equipment, I need to know how it functions. You can get that from things like the ABET, when we have items that are controlled by, not ABET, I'm sorry, when we have items controlled through our ASTM international standards. And so look at those, go look at instrument manufacturing companies and get a good explanation of how things have functioned. I would expect to see equations here as well. And equations need to be introduced. Equation one shows where A is blah, 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 blah. Don't give this way too much space. I keep seeing people do this. When we're introducing equations to you, it's because an equation is the star. When you use an equation, it is simply a tool. And so you don't want to give it too much empty space. And so here we want to have an explanation of how things function, any of the equations that might get utilized in the process. Methods would be the next section. And obviously, your theory might well take up a page or so. Because we have a theory section, the methods can be quite simple. I would like to know what are the samples. I'd like to know what instrument. I'd like to know what settings that are non-traditional. I'd like to know what manipulations and what corrections are formed. So very simple, past tense, technical. There's often an issue with people mixing the theory and the methods together. The theory is very general. Don't mention anything about your sample. Don't mention anything about the lab. It's how a particular piece of equipment functions and how data might be mathematically manipulated. For the methods, it's the pieces of information that somebody who is knowledgeable can go ahead and redo it. So technical, past tense. I'll give you instructions because you've never seen it before that are very step one, step two, step three. That's inappropriate style here. You're writing for people who know what they're doing, so this can be very simple. Of course, here's where the ASTMs, ASTM International is the star, and that's where it could be cited. In the introduction, of course, we've been citing the energy books because that's where you find how information, how the data is used. And you need to go to credible sources written for engineers. And so books are the way to go. After methods, we have results and discussion. So don't just put the data in. You always want to introduce the data. So there's going to be some sort of text. And then you're going to be showing your figures, or your table. You're going to introduce them before you show them. You're going to label them at the bottom. Fig one with enough information that I can understand what's going on. And you're going to label axes. You're going to put in error bars because obviously we need to work out what our uncertainty is in our data. And you're going to be the guide. You're not there to say, here's data, did I get it right? That's very much student mode. You want to be in guide mode, which is, here's the takeaway message, and then here's the data that backs it up. And so that's very much where you need to be. So how you communicate your information is partially how you're judged. You are also then going to have a conclusion section. And it's going to be bright pink for some reason, but that's okay. And with the data, you're going to explain how that data is also used. In the conclusion, it's a summary of the data. And recommendations, so showing how you have used that data. After that, we have our reference section, references. And there you have a listing. Again, energy books. That's where you have started off here. So that citation there will be the first one here. Chapter in a book. Maybe ASTMs. Maybe down the list, a journal article, if you'd like to know how things are being currently utilized. So, enough information here that I can judge the quality, and I know you're going to the appropriate locations. This is how you build credibility, that and using the appropriate terminology and showing you know your material. So the abstract, I said it had four different things in it. The first is how is the data used? And so here it's really going to be a paragraph on how that data is used. Here it gets distilled down to a couple of lines. How does industry use the data? And again, the audience is somebody technical, the boss's boss. No need to dumb it down. Get right into how the data is being utilized. No other fluff. The second part is the goals and approach. And when you finish your introduction, here, goals and approach get put in at the very end as well. The third part is the data with its interpretation. So you can't just dump in the data. You've also got to give it some sort of meaning. How do you get meaning from it? You compare it to other values and other expectations. The fourth piece is the so what, the use of the data. And so here, right, we have data, we have ability to use that data, and so do that next step and use it. And so you write the abstract last. Right? So small explanation of how the data is utilized. Keep the focus on the type of things that you're doing. So what you're trying to do, the instrument you might be utilizing. The ASTM is not the star. The ASTM is the star in the theory and perhaps in the methods. Here it's just very generic. A summary of the data that you found, again, presented in a useful manner. And then use that data. And so to be able to use it, you really have to know how that data is used in industry. And so energy books are the way to go. Theory, explanations, schematics, whatever helps explain how the instrument functions, equations, how the data is manipulated, corrections, read through the ASTM, and you can extract that information. Methods, very simple. Samples, instruments, non-normal settings, how you manipulate, corrections, if you did any corrections, how you did manipulations. The ASTM gets cited here, certainly gets cited here in the theory as well. Results and discussion, this is how we look to see if you're an engineer, can you be the guide? Can you create the takeaway message and then give the data that backs that up? And then at the end of that, it's utilizing that information. That's what makes you an engineer. Otherwise, you're just going to be a lab technician. The conclusion, again, you might want to start off with what you're trying to do and how you got there. And then really, it's a summary of the data and the recommendations of showing how you can utilize the data. And so engineers are problem solvers, you're decision makers. And you're not guessing. You've done the corrections and the manipulations to get to the point, and you know the decision points, right? If you know the decision points as to something is good or bad, acceptable, or needs to be changed, then this is where you can have your recommendations. Of course, we're going to have page numbers. References are going to be high quality because you're using the appropriate sources, and you're going to be a real engineer because you're going to know how things are utilized. So read up on expectations. After a few iterations of this, hopefully you will get better. Make sure you read the feedback. Use Adobe Acrobat so you can see all the various stamps that I'll put. If I don't like your title, I do great big X's through it and things like that. If you don't put how the data is used, I ask, you know, how the data is used in a great big stamp, and that'll give you some indication of how frustrated I am or how important it is that you change your ways. And so use Adobe Acrobat to see all the visualizations I get, and every time that you will see a bubble, that will have text information in it giving you additional feedback. Anyway, good luck, and I will see you in the class and in the lab.